Thanks, Mo. This poem, I wrote it a while ago, but I thought it'd be kind of fitting with this weekend's lack of rapture. When the world was ending, it was hard to get out of bed. But as usual, you splashed the day into your face, strapped the sun to your smile, and spent too long calculating your hair. Use your textbook to hold the doors and windows open so the air could get a breath of fresh you. There were still mistakes and meals to make, ideas to build, moms to make proud, father and Sundays to ache over, siblings to get close to, bow ties to justify, and top hats to top that. There were still women to learn and men to teach and stills to take to capture them. Opportunities to tech, book gardens to gaze, streets to peruse, friends to have, and time to lose. Still flowers to buy and lips to kiss, used books to dust and people to miss. There were still strangers to connect and old movies to collect. But when I got to your doorstep, all season Christmas lights and all rock and bow tie and bouquet, you took me in like a broken hammock. As if the world would fall apart if we laughed too hard, but we laughed too hard anyways. We pulled the sheets over our eyes and threw warm futures into the space before us and together kissed each other beneath what we would have been. Numbed by the sound of a soft voice, we spent the last day like we did every other, and I told you that you're beautiful, that you are a Philippine mango swell. Yes. That I pretend like every day of mine is some abstract summertime, but you are that concrete after rain smell. That I'm scared when you read the travel section, that you're the only person to find enough space between chest and chainmail to beat your heart into, and that people only think I love you is a cliche because they haven't met us yet. And I told you, on this last day of everything I've been scared to, I told you that my rapture includes you.